Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about new topic and the name of the topic is diseases. So in this lesson we are going to learn what is meant by diseases, what are the different types of symptoms, what are the different types of preventions we have to take and what are the different examples and different types of diseases. So subject science class 4th. So let's see what we are going to learn in this lesson. We are going to learn in this lesson diseases and the prevention. Second one, that is the types of diseases. Third one, we are going to learn about the prevention of various types of diseases. And fourth one, we are going to learn about the epidemics. So let's move towards the introduction. We will see what is diseases. What are the different types of diseases? So what is meant by diseases? When we are sick, we don't feel good and we are unable to work properly. That is called as a disease. A disease is a condition in which our body or a part of it does not function properly. Or we can call it as a disease is an unhealthy thing happening to the body or mind. And there are many different types of diseases that affect the human body. For example, common cold, chickenpox, malaria, asthma, diabetes and the corona. These are the some examples of the diseases. So let's see the first. What is symptoms? Means what are the different symbols? What are the different signs of that diseases? How we can identify that we are suffering from some diseases? That is called as a symptoms. That symptoms means the external sign shown by our body during an illness are called symptoms. That some external signs are called as a symptoms. When we are unwell, our body shows some external signs that something is wrong. That sign could be a runny nose, fever, cough, stomach pain, headache, shivering and the vomiting. These are the some external signs and all these signs are called as the symptoms. These signs are the symptoms. See, this is the one pictures of the symptoms. That redness, pain, fever, tiredness. These are all the examples of the symptoms. Here one picture of the girl. This shows that. That red patches, it is the symptoms. It is one type of diseases or it is one type of allergies. These external signs are called as the symptoms. So the next part we are going to learn in this lesson, different types of diseases. So let's see what are the different types of diseases. The first one, that is the non-communicable diseases. And second type, that is the communicable diseases. It means that there are two different types of diseases. Non-communicable diseases and the communicable diseases. So let's see what is meant by non-communicable diseases. That non-communicable diseases, a diseases that do not spread from one person to another are called non-communicable diseases. Or we can call it as a non-contagious diseases. It cannot spread from one person to another person, so it is called as non-contagious diseases. Second, that is the communicable diseases. What is meant by communicable diseases? The diseases that spread from one person to another are called as the communicable diseases or we can call as the infectious diseases. Means it can affect very quickly, very fastly to the another person. So it is called as the infectious diseases. So these are the some examples of communicable diseases, that is the chickenpox, measles, diphtheria, influenza, SARS. These are the some examples of the communicable diseases or one of the greatest and the important example of the communicable diseases, that is the coronavirus, that COVID-19. This is the one of the example of communicable diseases. It can spread from one person to another person. So it is called as an infectious diseases. So let's see one by one. The first we are going to discuss about the non-communicable diseases. That non-communicable diseases means diseases that do not spread from one person to another person. It is called as non-communicable diseases. Here I have shown one picture of the non-communicable diseases. It is regarding heart or some diabetes or some the cancers. These are the some examples of the non-communicable diseases. Some non-communicable diseases are caused due to the deficiency of nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins or minerals in our diet. So these are the some examples of the non-communicable diseases, which it causes due to the deficiency or due to the lacking of some nutrients in our food. These are called as the deficiency diseases because it causes a deficiency of nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins or minerals. It is called as a non-communicable diseases. So let's see the deficiency diseases, or we can call it as a non-communicable diseases. Here I have shown one table of the deficiency deficit. First column is about the deficiency diseases. Second one, that is the caused by the deficiency of. Third one, symptoms. And last one, food rich in nutrients. So the first one, that is the anemia. This anemia disease, it caused due to the deficiency of iron. And what are the symptoms of the anemia? Weakness, pale skin, or extreme fatigue. These are the some signs or the symbols of the anemia diseases. How to avoid this anemia, or in which food or in which vegetables or the fruits that iron is present? For example, eggs, pulses, dates, green leafy vegetables. These are the food rich in the iron. Second one, that is the goiter. That goiter is caused due to the lacking of iodine. And some symptoms of the goiter, that is the swelling of the thyroid gland present near the neck region. And what are the different food rich in that iodine? Fish, seafood, iodized salt. Third one, that is the night blindness. It is caused due to the lacking of vitamin A. That what is the vitamin, that night blindness, that person cannot see in the dim light or the night. This is the symptoms of the night blindness. And what are the different foods in that food that vitamin A is present in a more amount? That is carrot, spinach, milk, papaya, eggs, green leafy vegetables. Next one, we are going to discuss about the beriberi and pellagra. This is the cause. This is the deficiency of the vitamin B. And what are the different symptoms of this beriberi and pellagra? Skin beds become dry and scaly. Extreme weakness affect the nervous system and the muscles. And the food rich in the vitamin B, like milk, eggs, meat, green leafy vegetables and cereals. Next, we are going to discuss about the some again deficiency diseases. Next one, that is a scurvy. And it causes due to the lacking of vitamin C. And what are the symptoms of the scurvy? Swelling and bleeding of gums. Next one, amla, tomatoes and the citrus fruits like lemon and orange. These are the vegetables and the fruits are the food rich in the vitamin C. So if we have to avoid this scurvy diseases, we have to take the vitamin C, and these vitamin C are present in these vegetables and the food. Next one, that is the rickets. It caused due to the lacking of vitamin D. And what are the symptoms of the rickets? Bent legs, bending of the spine. And we have to take the milk, fish, eggs, and sunlight is also the important source of the vitamin D. And every day, every morning, and at the time of evening, we have to take this vitamin D. So we can avoid the rickets. Next one, we are going to learn about the marasms. This is the one of the diseases, and it causes due to the lacking of proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins and the fats. And what are the symptoms of this marasms? Child becomes so thin that loose fold of skin can be seen all over the body. And what are the different foods are available in that? Proteins, carbohydrates and fats are available in a more amount. That is rice, wheat, potatoes, maize, honey, ghee and the milk. So this is the deficiency chart, deficiency diseases. So we have to avoid that all these non-communicable diseases. So we have to take the important proteins, vegetables, carbohydrates, leafy vegetables and all vitamins in our food. Now the next, we are going to discuss about the some other causes of the diseases, like the liver and heart diseases, allergies, head stroke, prostate and hemophilia. So these are the some diseases that diseases causes due to the some internal organs do not work properly. Some allergies, it causes due to some harmful substances in food, air and water. That heat stroke causes extreme hot and the cold weather condition. And that hemophilia, it causes lacking of the iodine. So we have to, if we have to overcome of these diseases, we have to take the more amount of iodine that is present in the iodinized salt. So the next, we are going to discuss about the communicable diseases. It is very important type. So what is mean by communicable diseases? That diseases that spread from one person to another are called communicable or infectious diseases. It spread very quickly, very fastly from one person to the another person. And this disease is caused by the microorganism called germs. The microorganism like bacteria, virus and fungi are present everywhere in air, water or food. It means that through air, water and food, that microorganisms spread very quickly and affects the human body. And they can enter our body through various means and causes, and it causes the diseases. So these are the examples of the communicable diseases. So chickenpox, measles, influenza, SARS or the cough, these are the examples of communicable diseases like our COVID-19. So it spread very quickly through different various means like the air, water or the food. So next we are going to discuss about the different examples of the communicable diseases that, like the cholera, typhoid, hepatitis, influenza, tuberculosis. All these are the examples of the communicable diseases, or we can call as the infectious diseases. And it spread through food and water, air and mosquitoes. These are the mode of spread of communicable diseases. So the next we are going to learn about some communicable diseases that caused by the microorganism. So this is the one example of microorganism, that is the virus. So what are the different types of microorganism, like the bacteria, virus and the protozoa? So that because of bacteria, some diseases causes like cholera, pneumonia, tuberculosis, typhoid and the plague. And virus, this is the one example of virus, this is the COVID-19 virus. And due to the different types of virus, common cold, flu, polio, chickenpox, measles, AIDS, COVID-19, like that diseases causes. Next, microorganism like the protozoa. And due to the protozoa, that malaria, dysentery like diseases causes. So these are the different types of diseases. Now let's see again the different types of diseases based on the way that spread. Diseases are again different types, and it depends on through touching, eating, drinking and breathing. So let's see the first one, that is the airborne diseases. Second, waterborne diseases. Third one, through direct contact. Fourth one, through insects. And next one, that is through damaged skin. So that airborne diseases means the diseases that causes through the air. That is called as airborne diseases. Second, waterborne diseases means diseases that causes through water. It is called as the waterborne diseases. Third one, through direct contacts, means diseases that causes through touching. It is called as a through direct contact. Next one, through insect. Diseases that spread through insects, it is called as the through insect diseases. And next one, through damaged skin, it caused due to some allergies, and that allergies causes from the food or the air. So these are the different types of diseases. So let's see some prevention. What are the different preventions? How to take the preventions to overcome all these diseases? To keep diseases causing germs away from our body, it's called the prevention. If you want to avoid all these diseases, then we have to take care of us. That diseases causing germs, we have to away from our body. Then what are the different types of preventions are there that we can call? Every time that prevention is better than cure. The best way to protect our body from diseases is to prevent the diseases causing germs from entering our body. We have to avoid all these diseases, so we have to take some prevention. So what are the different prevention? Here I have shown one picture. It is very important. We have to wash our hand daily before and after eating. We have to wash our hands after 10 to 15 minutes. We can avoid many germs enter into our body. So the first we are going to discuss about the prevention of airborne diseases. So how to take the prevention of airborne diseases? That use a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Next one, that is the wear a mask in crowded place. Third one, do not spit here and there. Next one, keep the doors and the windows open in the morning and the evening. And through vaccination also we can avoid the many different types of diseases like the tuberculosis and the measles. Second, that is the prevention of diseases that spread through touch. So wash both hands with soap and water. We can avoid the many different types of diseases that spread through the touch. Third one, that is the prevention of waterborne diseases. Avoid that cold water. So because of that cold water, ice and the ice cream, many types of diseases happens. So we have to drink the purified water, or we can drink the RO water. So boiling water is also one of the important things. Means we have to drink the boiled water, we have to use the boiled water, we can avoid the different types of waterborne diseases. This is one of the important preventions while drinking the waters. Through vaccination also we can avoid the different types of diseases like the typhoid, hepatitis, polio. We can avoid these different types of diseases through the vaccination. Next one, prevention of diseases that spread by the insects. That mosquitoes spread many harmful diseases. If we have to avoid all these diseases, then we have to use some lotions or the repellent cream so we can avoid the different types of diseases that spread through the insects. That housefly causes the diseases like typhoid and the cholera. They carry germs from the dirty place and dustbin and so on. They lay eggs in a moist or the dark and the dirty areas. So we should keep our house and the surroundings clean and moisture free. Also, we should keep food items in a closed vessel to prevent the different types of diseases. So we can avoid the different types of diseases. These are the preventions of the communicable diseases. So the next we are going to learn about the prevention of the non-communicable diseases. So this picture shows that we have to eat the vegetables, fruits daily. Next picture tells us we have to do the exercise and yoga every day. We can avoid the many different types of diseases by using the exercise and the yoga, because exercise and yoga keep us healthy and strong. We can increase our heartbeat rate also by doing the different types of exercise and the yoga. Third one, playing outdoor games. That playing outdoor games, it is also one of the important preventions to avoid the non-communicable diseases. Next one, avoid the junk food. We have to eat that fresh vegetables, fruits every day. Next one, we have to take the rest at least 7 to 8 hours in a daily so we can avoid the different types of diseases. Third one, that is the diet chart. So we have to use the diet chart every day in our daily diet. See, different types of that diet chart. In that diet chart, different types of vegetables and fruits are available. We have to eat the different types of vegetables and fruit. Then we should also exercise and the play outdoor games. People who lives in a city should wear the special different types of the mask when they go outdoors to protect themselves from the dust and the smoke in the air. And next important thing, that we should stay relaxed and the happy. Being worried about anything or being angry makes our body weak, which can make us unhealthy. In spite of taking all the care, if we suffer from any diseases, we should go to the doctor. This is very important prevention. The doctor diagnoses the diseases and gives medicine to treat. So the last part we are going to learn in this lesson, that is the epidemics. It is the very important topic we are going to discuss. That epidemics means sometimes some diseases that affect lots of people at the same time. They spread very quickly and very difficult to control. These diseases causes a great loss of human life. Such diseases are called as epidemics. And nowadays, the best example of epidemics, that is the corona. So it spread very quickly, very fastly. We cannot control these diseases. So we have seen that in many countries like the America, the China, or in other places also, and now it's India also, that coronavirus, that corona diseases is spread very quickly and very fastly. We called as the epidemics. That smallpox, plague, yellow fever, malaria, these are also examples of the epidemics. This picture shows that diseases spread very quickly from one person to the another person in a group. So if we have to avoid these epidemics, we have to avoid the crowd places. These are the examples of epidemics. So in these days, if we have to avoid like that diseases, that the corona or the epidemics, so we have to avoid the crowd places and we have to stay at our home and we have to stay safe. So this is the message regarding epidemics. So thank you all of you. I hope everyone understood the diseases and the types of diseases. If you like this video, please like and subscribe it. Thank you, everyone.